Okay, so this is a small video on how to set up Attract Mode with MAME. First, create a My Arcada folder in your C drive or any other drive, but I will be using C drive. Go to Google, search for download Attract Mode, Attract Mode frontend, download, and download the binary. Then search for download attract Nevato layout. Download Nevato theme. Download theme. You will also need Scraper UI, so Scraper. .NET, I think. Yes. Go to download. Download for Windows. Okay. So we have the scraper. We also need MAME, so download MAME. And download MAME. Okay, so first attract. Extract to My Arcade. Let me show it this way. Say My Arcade attract and extract. Then the MAME is almost finished. Okay. Extract to say My Arcade. We are going to create a new folder. Emulators. Okay, and another new folder, MAME. Press OK, press Extract. So it's extracting. Go to the Nevato theme download. Extract this to C. This should come in the layouts folder of Attract. So C, My Arcade, Attract, Layouts. Okay. Next, you should also have downloaded some ROMs or a ROMs pack or something. I'm just going to show to copy a few of mine. So I'm going to copy a few ROMs, simulating the downloads. So three wonders. 1942. What is it? I don't have it anymore. Doesn't matter. Now it's here. 1943, 1942. Let me check a bit further. I'm not going to choose many. No, just some more. So, suppose you have downloaded them. You place them in C, My Arcade, Emulators, MAME, ROMs. Always place your ROMs in there for MAME. So we have the emulator. We have the emulation tools. Create a folder. Metadata. Okay, attract. Create also a folder. ROMs. This is mainly a placeholder for the future when you add new systems. So now go to metadata. Create a folder. MAME. En in hier create 5 folders. Van Aert. Wiel. Flyer. Screenshot. What else? Snap. Snap is usually the video, but you can also place screenshots inside it. So now we have fanart, flyer, screenshot, snap, wheel, marquee we also need. Let me first delete the video. So that I have enough space. Okay. So we set it up the folders, which will contain our metadata. So now we are going to set up Attract. Go to the Attract folder. And start Attract. Choose your language. I chose English. Go to Emulators. Add emulator, name it main, or no, arcade. You can choose a template, choose main, because we chose a main, and then it will have set up main. The executable should be main64.exe, because I downloaded the 64-bit version. The command argument should be main, but also add skip game info. This will skip the little game information screen when starting the ROM. The working directory is C, my arcade, emulators, main. This is the location where the main 64 binary is, so where the executable is. And as you can see, if we go to the my arcade, emulators, MAME64. See, C, my arcade, emulators, MAME, and MAME64. So that's correct. The ROM path. This is the location of the ROM folder. So C, my arcade, emulators, MAME, ROMs. It should search for 7-zip and zip, that's good. The system identifier is arcade, that's good. List.xml. Ah yeah, I forgot to mention we need to download some other files. Search for Orghetto snaps. En klik de katver.ini file. En dan klik download katlist katver.ini. Dan search voor MAME en players.ini. These files contain categories data en de the number of players. You can, I think you can you play a game with. So extract this to the ini. Extract to say my arcade MAME extras. And then the katver in the same location. The katver.ini. So C, my arcade, MAME extras. Okay, let's go back to Attract. So additional import files. We have to supply them now. So C, my arcade, MAME extras, katver.ini. C, semicolon hier, to separate the different files. C, my arcade, main extras, and players.ini. Okay. Now we are going to set up the locations of the folders. So Artwork label marquee is C my arcade meta data. Let me check if the folder is correct. My arcade metadata main marquee. Main marquee. Back. Snap. C my arcade meme metadata meme. What is it? Snap. Okay. We are going to add flyer. C my arcade metadata main flyer. These are the folders here. So next is wheel. Add artwork, artwork label wheel. Add artwork part C. My arcade. Main. No, metadata. Main. My arcade metadata main wheel. Okay, fanart is also fanart artwork part C my arcade metadata main fanart. Let me check if I forgot a folder. Yes, I forgot a folder screenshot. So that screenshot. Artwork park C my arcade main metadata main screenshot. Okay, fanart. Okay, then you have to choose for generate collection ROM list. It will create a ROM list, a file containing all the names of your ROMs with extra data. This can take a very long time if you have many ROMs. So go drink a coffee or something and let it do its job. So I'm doing it now, but with me it should not take so much time because I have not so many ROMs. Okay, this is done. Now if we exit out, you should see the names. In theory, if I press enter to start one, it should start main and launch the game. Yes, it does it. If I select another one, it should do it also. No, this is a bad ROM. Also a bad ROM. I chose all bad ROMs. Now this one is working. Probably because my ROMs and my main version are not from the same version. So yeah. And I press escape to exit. But now you see, we have a standard layout. So I'm going to change it to displays, arcade. It uses the ROM list for arcade, yes. And emulator. No, that's okay. It already created it. But go to layout and change it to Nevato. Let's escape. And now you see the Nevato theme, but as you can see, we don't have any media. So now we go back, we exit Attract. Yes. And we go to the download for Scraper UI. and you extract it to say my arcade emulation tools. You should create this folder, I already had it, and then scraper, and then press OK. I'm going to cancel it because otherwise I have to restart downloading all the metadata. So go to this tool, my arcade emulation tools, scraper, run scraper UI. Let's hope it works. With you, it will start in basic mode. So click on switch to expert mode. Click, and it should also come with this wizard. So let me restart it. You should create an account and then enter your credentials and press validate. I think you already did this, or some people already did this. Then next, then choose generic emulation. Choose the folder where your ROMs are. This should not be the main folder. This should be the placeholder folder I created in the My Arcade directory. Let me see, where's my, oh shit, I chose network, it's going to hang. Okay, so this PC, say, my arcade, ROMs. Normally you should have, if you have Genesis ROMs, you put ROMs Genesis. If you have Game Boy Advance ROMs, ROMs GBA. If you have Game Boy games, ROMs GB, etc. But since we don't have, I'm only setting up MAME, I created this folder, but you should do it there. And then it will detect it automatically. So click finish. It didn't detect any systems, so we are going to add MAME. Click add. Remove the show categories function and search for MAME. Click OK. Then we go to games and frontend. Yes. Use specific configuration for MAME. It should be saved. But say my arcade ROMs MAME is not the correct location. We have the ROMs installed in C. My arcade emulators MAME ROMs. MAME is a special version. Let me check other things. That's correct. So go to media. Select use specific configuration for media. Make sure cleanup output folder before generating new media is not checked. Remove any images here using this button and add a new one. The first one should be the video. Okay. The folder location is not correct, so we click the folder location. And now we are going to select the folders we had created. That's in My Arcade, Metadata, MAME, and the video. The video should go in Snap. Then we add a new one. This should be an image. A screenshot. Also, the screenshot, select the folder. Add a new one. This should be a screenshot, a meme image, and select Arcade Marquee. You should only select Arcade Marquee for arcade games. Also, select the Marquee folder. Say my arcade metadata main Marquee. If you have other systems, you would select here the other system, but it can auto detect it normally if you have many folders. So now we have the screenshot video. We need the wheel. So add another one. Change it to image, select wheel, okay. And we also need a flyer, but they don't provide flyers, so we select fanart. So also select image, fanart, and select the fanart folder. Okay, so now we have set up our folder locations. You can very, oh, this one has not been done, the wheel. So I have to select the wheel. You can verify them by clicking on each of the images and going here to the left or to the right. So verify them that the locations are correct. Once they are correct, select the meme here and press the play button. Now it will start scraping metadata like videos, screenshots, wheel images, etc. So it has finished. And if you go look in the My Arcade folder, in the metadata meme, it should have created some metadata, each with its own folder with the name of your game, of your ROM. So, it's acting slow again. Okay. So screenshot, snap, his video, and our wheels. So in theory, if we start attract model now and I haven't made any fault, we should see the media now with an Evato layout. There we go. We see the wheels, three wonders, etc. Suppose you want to delete a ROM. You go to the ROMs folder of MAME. Let me exit attract. Say my arcade emulators, MAME, ROMs. I don't want Raiden KB. I will delete the two MAME Raidens. We have deleted the ROM, but as you will see, when I start Attract, it will still be visible. The reason is Attract uses ROM lists, and it's still located in the ROM list. But there is a way to make sure if you delete a ROM, you don't always have to regenerate the ROM list. So I will show that now. Restart Attract. As you can see, the Raiden ones are still there. So go to the press tab and go to displays, Arcada, add the global filter, add rule, target, file, exists, file is available, comparison equals 1. This will make sure it only shows games that are still available. Now, if I go back to the ROM, it's gone. Okay, that's that. So now, suppose you downloaded more ROMs. I'm going to select a few more. This might not be good, but let's see. That's a ROM folder. Let me go to my good folder. Let's take one of the Street Fighter games. Street Fighter, Street Fighter 2. What else is here? PC is acting slow again. I don't know all these names, but let me check one. These are bad ones. Tumblepop. I know that as media. It doesn't matter. Select just one other one. So you had downloaded some more ROMs. You placed them in your My Arcade. Emulators, MAME, ROMs directory. So you extract them. You don't have to extract the files. Just place the zip files there. And we start Attract again. And you would think the ROMs would show up. But As you can see, that's not the case. And why not? Because the ROMs are not in the ROMs list here. And you can fix that by going to the emulator, Arcade, and select Generate Collection ROM List again. The more ROMs you have, the longer these will take. So now it's searching for the new ROMs, but also removing the old ROMs that are not available anymore. And as you can see, we have new games available, but we don't have the media. So you go to the scraper, and you scrape again. Normally you wouldn't do this a lot of times because it can take a very long time. Normally you would download a set, and you have the set, and you would check the ROMs and do it once. So now it's checking for the other games. Okay. And I'm going to delete a video on purpose. Emulators. Mame extras? No. Metadata. Mame. Snap are the videos. So I know Three Wonders has a video. And Three Wonders also has a screenshot. But as you will see, when I go to Arcade, Attract, and I start Attract, and we go to Three Wonders. Three Wonders, the video is not showing, and even though we had a screenshot. So you can fix that by doing the following. You go back to emulators, you go to Arcade, you go to the snap folder, and you also add the screenshot folder with a semicolon. So first a semicolon, say my arcade metadata mame screenshot. And now when going back, it does detect the picture and it shows the picture. If you have both a picture and a video, it should show the video first. As you can see with the other ROMs. This one we don't have a wheel for, so the scraper didn't find it, so yeah. That's why I prefer named lists, then you can see the name of the list. You can also see the background. Suppose you have flyers, then you go to display and you prefer to see the flyers. You go to Arcade and then layout options, and here you can choose what do you want to see. I don't want to see the marquee, but I want to see the emulator name. And then it shows Arcade. Or you do want to see the marquee, then you go back to the display, the layout options, and you select marquee. Or spin wheel art should be the marquee instead of the wheel. So you can play a lot with these things. Or each layout has its own options. So let me put it back. But suppose you download the flyers from Provetor Snap, then you can change it to flyer here. Or if you don't want to see it, you select none. Then you have a simple view like this. So, okay, if we start the game, it works. Okay, I'm going to show you one more thing. I'm going to assign a button in controls to filters menu. So I delete, at input, F. When I press F, I get the filters menu. So I press F, okay. And I'm going, remember, if you're going to the ROMs list, Arcade, these things, slot machine, video, or sorry, yeah, fighter versus or shooter flying. That's being added with the MAME extras, with the katver.ini and the players.ini. The players.ini is the joysticks and the katver.ini adds these categories. That's only valid for MAME. But suppose you want to set a filter on shooter games, you can copy the text between brackets or just shooter. And you go to the display, arcade. And you go to auto filter, name it shooter. You set auto rule, target is category, comparisons contains, this is case sensitive, eh? And then you paste shooter, back, and now if I press my key, the F key I assigned, I can choose shooter, and it only shows shooters. If I press F and I select F, all, it shows all games again. So you can create filters or categories in your list like this. So yeah, I think I've said most of it. It should work for most games. And I hope you can go a bit further now with everything. Thanks.